श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। I welcome you all for this fifth day of our Gita Sar series. So I hope you're understanding the flow. So the first day we saw Jiva, who am I? We're not this body, but a spirit soul. Second day we saw, yes, there's a God who controls this nature. And we are suffering because we're separated from that God. Right? There. And God always wants for good. He's very, very merciful. Third day we saw the karma, how the karma acts. And how by taking shelter of Lord, we can come out of karma like Vibhishan, right? By chanting the holy names of the Lord. And yesterday, the fourth day, we saw Ishvara, the Supreme Personality of Godhead is Lord Shri Krishna, who is a person with whom we can have relationship, we can worship him, and he is a goal for all the bhaktas there. And today, we are going to see the fifth subject of Bhagavad Gita, Kala, time. Just imagine the power of this time. Just 1 month before, you know, or 2 months before, in India, 15 March, everybody was talking, you know, COVID will go away. And we were also thinking in June, we'll be very nicely roaming. In fact, we had gone for a yatra also to Vrindavan yatra. We went in the March month and everything was going very nicely. And now so much problems in this world. So many people are getting affected. There, the power of time. Everybody is locked down in the home. Even we see last year in February, nobody will think that any time, you know, flights can stop, trains can stop. But within two months' time, everything stopped. So this is the power of time. It can make impossible possible. It can make possible impossible. There, where we were, just think about where we were 100 years before and where we'll be after 100 years, right? None of us were there 100 years before. Is anybody was there 100 years before here? Who has come here? None of us. Now, can anybody say you will be there after 100 years? None of us can say. So this is a power of time. Everything it takes a bit of kala of the Lord, the kala chakra. And therefore, it's something very, very important to understand this kala. And says, Ayur Harati Vaipumsam, Odhyanasto Chayanso, Tasarite Shadonita, Uttam Shoka Vartaya. With every rising and setting of sun, it is taking away our life duration, except for one who is a devotee of the Lord, who is hearing about the Lord. Right? For him, he's coming closer to God. He's coming closer to God. Now, I'll ask one example to you before we begin the session. What's the difference between a cat holding a kitten? Cat holding a kitten and cat holding a mouse. Will anyone want to like to say anything? What is the difference between a cat holding a kitten? Kitten, you understand? Cat's child. And mouse is cat's prey. So what is the difference? Both cases, cat holds from the mouth only. So what is the difference between the two? Yes, any answers? Please raise your hand or you can write in the chat. What's the difference between the two? I'm not getting any response. Are you not able to think? Or if you raise your hand, we can open your video. Okay, giving life and taking life. Sunil Sharma, very nice. Yes, any other response? What's the difference between the two? Yes, Rajneesh.
Yeah, so in both the cases, the intentions are different.
Yeah, what is the intention?
Yeah, it's already said that one is to take the life and one is to give the life.
Yes, Mansa Mata written, one is hurt, other is love. So very nice. And yeah, as you said, intentions are different. Very good there. There is love and there is enmity. Love and survival, care versus danger. Now, same way, death, the Kala treats devotees and non-devotees like kitten and rat. So those who are devotees of the Lord, the Kala treats them like a mouse. And those who are not devotees, who are not prepared for the final exam, the time factor deals them as a mouse and devotees it treats as kitten. So cat loves his child kitten, right? And he holds with a soft mouth. And for a rat, for a mouse, is going to devour. The same way, for somebody who is not prepared for death, it looks that everything will end. But for a person who is developing his relationship with God, who is prepared for that final exam, it appears like a cat holding a mouse. And he knows because when his final time is coming, he's going back home, back to God. He's going to enjoy with the Lord in the spiritual world. He's always going to be with his loved one. And that's why he feels like that. And devotee surpasses the pain of death. Like many times people may ask, did even devotees leave their body? And there have been cases where great senior devotees, even in ISKCON, they left their body due to COVID. But they could see that they are going back to Golok Vrindavan. They are going back to the spiritual world. So this is how the concept, you know, of Kala is there. So why I'm saying all this, now as you are chanting the holy names of the Lord, as all of you are becoming devotees of the Lord, so to the degree you do it, you'll become free from the fear of death. Yes, to the all of us, to the degree we take to spiritual life, to the degree we do it, we are getting out of the Kala factor. And the fear of death, the fear of other things will go away in this life. And this is the first thing spirituality provides. This knowledge of Bhagavad Gita provides us freedom from fear. And that is so beautiful and amazing, this freedom of fear, which is provided by Bhagavad Gita. So with that, we continue our presentation. So explanation based on three modes. Okay, sorry. It's just, once again, let's go to the English. You see the timer. So five topics we have learned. So today is Kala, time. So today, why there's constant change in this world? Everything is changing in this world. What happens after death? What is this Kala? To understand how this time factor works. Definition, is there a place? Yeah. Is there a place where there is no influence of time? Right? Is there a place where there's no influence of time, which is always and coming to mode of goodness and beyond? Okay. So let us first see this. We want to remain young forever, but quickly we grow old. We look no longer beautiful. No one wants to grow old, but old age comes. You know, this McDonald's, he gave some $20 million to the scientist and to keep his body and to research that can we stop death. And his relatives paid another $20 million to dispose his body because they were fearful if he get up, then he'll again take up the property. But still nobody could found a cause for death in this world. See, and we discussed this, our bodies grow from old to generate.
Most people spend their lives wrapped up in rushing to and fro. As time flows quickly by, days, months, and years rush by in the blink of an eye. Yet for some reason, people try to ignore this fact. It is as if they think they will never grow old. Yet the days of youth that they so fondly imagine will never end are really very short. Almost everyone realizes that he will grow old one day. Yet young people always feel that those days are very far off. They refuse to accept that they will one day be old, weak, and helpless. The two young people in this picture are good-looking, with clean and perfect skins and shining teeth. But there is another important detail. These pictures were taken in 1955. When this picture was taken, these two were most probably not giving any thought to the fact that they would one day grow old. Yet some 50 years or more have now gone by, and nothing remains of the youth and beauty in the picture. Destroys everything. That is a law of the world.
death comes an ultimate end to all of our. So jatasya vi dhruva mrityu jana mrityu sacha tasmat parihaya arthe natam shochitam arasi. One has taken his birth sure to die, and after death one is sure to take birth again. Therefore, in the unavoidable discharge of your duty, you should not lament. So on what basis soul awarded the next body? Yam yam vapi smarandhava tajante ante kalevaram tam tam evedi kantaya sudha tadabhava bhavitaha. Whatever state of being one remembers when he quits his body, O son of Kunti, that state he will attain without fail. Why? What one is remembering at the time of death. So if one is somebody is thinking of a tiger, he becomes a tiger. Somebody thinking of a rabbit, he becomes a rabbit. Based on his desire and karma. There. So this is a beautiful story of Raghav Das. He was a devotee. He practiced for 1 year. And he had a reincarnation. And he became Ratnavali Dasi. So are you interested to know about the story? It's a beautiful story of Ratnavali. So what is this story all about? Hear very carefully, right? So there are many lessons to learn, and this is a real life story. It happened in London, in within ISKCON itself, and the one senior sannyasi, Bhakti Swaminathan Bhakti Charu Maharaj, had personally confirmed this story. I was there where he confirmed that yes, this story was a true story. So is a very powerful reincarnation. So there was a girl born in London in 1975, 9th August. Okay, maybe I'll share the documents so that while I'm narrating, you will also see the some details of it. So Hindu, she was born in 9th August 1975 in London. While she was maybe 16 years old, she was brutally attacked in the college. And while she was in the college, what happened is she was attacked brutally, and a voice came from within her heart, pretend as if you're dead. And she pretended, and then person went away. And then the voice again spoke, now run away again, that person will come back. And she ran back, and she was very thankful that her life was saved. Now in 92, she got a Bhagavad Gita in London from devotees. And when she read Bhagavad Gita, she got convinced that voice was of Krishna. Then she went to temple. She saw the address behind that Bhagavad Gita, went to temple. And when she saw the deities of Radha Langaneshwar, there were tears in her eyes. And in 97, he married to a devotee and took initiation from His Holiness Bhakti Charu Swami Maharaj. Now in 2000, she was very attracted to Tribhuvanath Prabhu's Sangeet. And Tribhuvanath Prabhu was a brahmachari. So he would do Sankirtan on Saturdays. And she found that she could, though she was a lady, but she could play the drum very nicely with Tribhuvanath Prabhu. There. And then she was running away. She was thinking, I'm a woman. So she was moving aside from Tribhuvanath Prabhu. And Tribhuvanath Prabhu said, I don't be bodily conscious. You play the drum nicely. So she felt that Tribhuvanath Prabhu treated her like a brahmachari. So now why I'm telling these details, you'll come to understand. In 2001, she had a dream again. That as Harinam increased, the obstacle decreased. Finally, I opened a door and there was Srila Prabhupada sitting at a table. I started crying on his lap. He looked at me in compassion and said, come, many people want to speak about you, but there is nothing left for you to do but simply chant Hare Krishna. Then the dream ended. Then as she was married, now her husband went into healing regression. Sometimes they have a healing regression, and he saw that he was a brahmachari in last life, as a male devotee in last life. Then now she went to another dream that she is in Scotland, she is going to Scotland, she is in a, she is first saw in a temple, then a hospital ward, and he saw that the temple turned to a park. And then she was chanting japa in a park. And she saw one devotee, Krishnadas Prabhu, and she felt that she has seen her. Now, one day while she went to one, meet devotee, she saw Krishnadas Prabhu. And she felt that she had seen Krishnadas Prabhu before, though she was seeing her first time. So now so many dreams have started coming in her mind and disturbing her. Sometimes she had a dream that she is getting a car accident in past life. She is there. So then she asked five Srila Prabhupada disciples to know, was there any brahmachari who died before 1974? Because see, she was born in 1975. So that means she was conceived 9 months before. So before 1974, was there any brahmachari who died, who had loved Harinam and he was connected to London temple and especially Tiruvannath Prabhu? Then she came to know the life of Raghav Das. He was born in 1954 and died in 1973. His name was David Hoyer. Born in Glasgow, father committed suicide. So at 17, he came to Edinburgh temple and joined the temple. And for 1 year, he was staying there. And then David and Tiruvannath Prabhu, the Tiruvannath Prabhu, the same, you know, brahmachari who treated this Mataji as a brahmachari. So David and Tiruvannath Prabhu played drums together. Sometimes they went to London also. And then this David Hoye received initiation, name was Raghav Das. Raghav Das. Now after initiation, Srila Prabhupada, he became Srila Prabhupada's disciple. And after initiation, after a few time up there, Krishna Das Prabhu was going and taking Raghav Das Prabhu. And he felt asleep on his steering vehicle, Krishna Das Prabhu, and Raghav died in that accident. Krishna Das Prabhu saved, but Raghav Das died. So then Prabhupada came to him and Prabhupada said, certainly Krishna will give him a good place to take birth where he can begin in Krishna conscious activity. That is sure. But we offer our condolence to a departed soul separated from a Vaishnava and there should be prasadam distributed. Now she asked her Guru Maharaj, can I do past life regression? So she did two regressions. And both regressions showed that this Ratnavali was a young brahmachari performing Harinam with Tiruvannath Prabhu. And there were some scenes of Srila Prabhupada which made her very emotional. And after both regression, the following mornings, he had exactly the same dream that a man with long hair fall asleep on the steering wheel and I'm in the back of the vehicle and feeling him. And then he had a dream that Krishna Das Prabhu was calling out, Raghav, Raghav, Raghav. And after a few weeks, she had another dream where she is trying to tell him that I was his old friend Raghav, but he could not see me. So she had many, many vehicles. And finally, she told to Krishna Das Prabhu, Prabhu, I'm back. Don't worry. You didn't kill me. Because Krishna Das Prabhu was very, very sensitive. Krishna Das Prabhu was very, very sensitive that because of him, one devotee passed away. Right? So now when he came to know, no, that devotee is still back as Raghav, as Ratnavali. So he was quite comforted in his heart. And then she had many nightmares of vehicles crashes that seemed to be ongoing and horrific. I also had a few dreams of Edinburgh, such as going to the stair of Edinburgh temple for a Srimad Bhagavatam class. Now she found the proofs of this connection of what she saw. What she found, once she and her husband went to Edinburgh temple and they found the same power which came in a dream. In fact, Dhenuvati Mataji told her, one Dhenuvati, who was the previous wife of Krishna Das Prabhu, that when Raghav Das was bit by a dog in the same park, and she came that I will never go. And she had a dream, a dog biting her in the hand. And she will be very fearful of dogs. And the old temple had turned to her pub. What was the old Edinburgh temple? That was the spiral pub she was seeing. And then Krishna Das Prabhu was very relieved that he came to know Raghav Das has come. Now once Bhakti Charu Maharaj joked to her, who was that girl whom you were thinking at the time of death or Raghav? Because like we said, whatever you remember at the time of death, you get dead body. So now she got a girl's body, woman body. So that means Raghav Das would be singing of some Mataji and that song, he got a woman body. So she took it seriously and she inquired, was there a girl whom Raghav was attracted to or attached to? And she, Dhenuvati told that there was an Indian girl named Satyavati, whom Raghav would stare at, you know, while chanting his japa there. And then she had a lot of curiosity that let me actually go and meet that girl. So he meant that Mataji, who's become old, elderly now, by now, you know, 20, 30 years have passed. So she went and gave her sweets. And what she found that her face cut, especially eyes, eyebrows, nose, exactly matched that of Satyavati. There. So this is a real life story. So you see, this Raghav Das, I'll just explain the story a little more. This Raghav Das was living in Edinburgh temple. So he was connected with Tiruvannath Prabhu and came to meet and they will come to London also quite often, and they will go back and fro there. So now this Mataji became very, she was, this Raghav Das both were doing service, and they will do jump up and down, you know, do kirtan together. Now Raghav Das died, but again, she was born, he was born in an Indian family as Ratnavali Mataji, because he, at the time of death, he remembered that devotee girl, Satyavati. So he became a devotee. And Krishna made sure that he again became a devotee. She again came back in devotee association with the same devotee association, and Edinburgh and London temple, the same temple, and continued her service to Srila Prabhupada. Right? So this is how the life of a devotee goes. Even something happens to him, again he takes birth and continues his devotional service there. So this is the beauty of Krishna consciousness. In this material world, even somebody becomes a captain of a ship. Somebody becomes a CEO. Again, next life we have to start with Baba, Blanchard. But whatever devotional service, whatever devotion to God we do, you know, 10%, 20%, next life we carry from 11%, 21%, 22%. So death also cannot do any bad to a devotee. So this is the beauty of becoming a devotee of God. And this is a very special case of reincarnation. Okay, I think there's a question from Pradeep Prabhu. Yes. Pradeep Prabhu would like to ask. They're not able to unmute. You can unmute and then ask a question, Pradeep Prabhu. Okay. So any question on this story before we go ahead? Did you understand the story nicely? Understood the lesson, understood the story. And Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, when Arjuna asks Krishna, Krishna, what happens to an unsuccessful yogi? Like somebody is, you know, practicing bhakti and he's not able to complete. What happens? Then Krishna said, it doesn't happen. He again comes back in the, if he has material desire, he goes to heaven and come back. Again, if he doesn't have much material desire, then he again come back as a devotee. Come back again as a yogi in a family of devotees there. Yes, Vikram.
Krishna Prabhuji, is it good to do the past life regression or not?
No, it's not recommended. Because in her life, she was getting very troubled dreams. That's why she was told to do past life regression. See, by philosophy only we understand that yes, we had a past life and that's why we are here. So now what is the means, benefit of knowing it? So chant Hare Krishna and go back to Godhead. I don't know, it may have sometime some, you know, effects, some, you know, side effects also, regression and other things. So we generally don't recommend there. Okay, there's another question from Shivangi. Yeah.
If we get to know something about the past, does it change anything? Like in past regression, if we get to know about a past life, does it change the present life in any way?
No. See, like whatever life stories I told of fighter pilot, though they remember their past life, still their life continues the same way. In fact, they were more troubled because the troubles of past life also start troubling them. So therefore, it is not advised to do past life regression, but she was already getting troubles, you know, of her last life there. Then that's why she did there. Otherwise, generally, it is not recommended. So I told this story not to inspire people for past life regression, but to explain the principle, yes, past life happens, and that's what the circumstances we do. So what is the main inspiration we get from the story, that how for a devotee, life never ends. It continues from one life to another, whatever situation one is in there. So when we understand this, how life is temporary, and let us give time for God, because that relationship is only eternal. Because ultimately she was disciple of Srila Prabhupada, now she became a grand disciple of Srila Prabhupada, right? And she remembered Krishna. Krishna again came in his life, whatever she did there. And because last life she could only practice for 1 year, right? Raghav Das there. But this life she gave whole life, so she will go back to God there. So glorious is the life of a devotee. So now all of you are coming. So if you take a resolution, no, now we take the spiritual life very seriously and start practicing the spiritual life. So what will happen? So whatever is there, this whole life you practice it, you perfect life and go back to Godhead. Now what is that Godhead we are going to discuss now? Right? So Lord showed the universal form to Arjuna on the battlefield. Right? So because Arjuna asked to show the universal form, if somebody says I am God, then they should show universal form also, right? Otherwise, how can somebody claim himself to be God? So Shri Bhagavan Vacha, Pashye me patrupani shashovat sahastrasha nana vidani devyani nana varnakriti nicha. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, my dear Arjuna, O son of Partha, see now my opulences, hundreds of thousands of very divine and multicolored forms. Right? So see now my opulences, hundreds of thousands of very divine and multicolored forms. So this is a universal form, you know, Krishna showed. And Arjuna said, my dear Lord Krishna, I see assembly in the body, all the demigods, various other living entities, I see Brahma, I see Shiva. O Lord of the universe, O universal form, I see in your body many, many arms, bellies, mouths, eyes, expanded everywhere without limit. I see in you no end, no middle, and no beginning. And then Lord showed the Kala Rupa. So what he showed in the Kala Rupa, that all sons of Dhritarashtra, Duryodhana, Bhishma, Drona, Karna, were already going in the mouth of Kala Rupa. So what did Lord say to Arjuna? Arjuna have already killed everybody. You have to just become Nimitamat Bhavya Sabhya Sacha. And some I see to them. So the Lord manifests the Kala Rupa, the destroyer of all the world. So all those people who were involved in disrobing Draupadi, they all were killed there. Including Bhishma, Drona, Karna, Duryodhana, and even soldiers on the side of the Pandavas. So it was a Kala Rupa who had come. But on the other side, anybody who was killed on the battlefield, seeing the Lord, they all went to the spiritual world. They all got liberation, right? There. So though Lord destroyed them, but because the Lord was personally present, he mercifully gave them higher destination, which is mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam there. So when we see a mass destruction happening, you can understand the Kala Rupa has come, the Kala has come there. And only a devotee can surpass Kala, nobody else can surpass Kala in this world. It is as sure as death. So just like on our head, on a medicine, expiry date is there. Same way on our head, expiry date is already written, but we don't know when the expiry date is there. Only in case of a devotee who is using this life for coming closer to God, God may postpone. Okay, let me give him 10, 20 years because anyway, he's using it to come to me. But in general, other cases, it's as sure as death. It's quite fixed. And Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, Kalosmi, Lokashaya Krit Prapaddo, Lokan Samahartum, Hima Pravattaha, Vite Api Tamna Bhavishanti Sarve, Yavastita Pratte Nikeshi Yoda. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, time I am the greatest destroyer of the worlds, and I have come here to destroy all people. With the exception of you, the Pandavas, all the soldiers here on both sides will be slain. So already Krishna told, whether Arjuna you fight or not fight, I have already killed everybody. Now you want to become instrument, you become there. So now that means what? Kala is the energy of the Lord. The Lord, the time represents the Lord in this material world. So therefore people ask question, if God created everything, who created God? I think God is the cause of all cases. Why? Because time is in control of God. See, when we see something is created, something is destroyed, that means we put in the reference of time. But the time is a representative of God in this world, and God is beyond the influence of time. So God is the one who created everything. In fact, he is the master of time also, where the concept of cause and effect comes, where the conception of creation and destruction comes. So for example, I gave up this Tiran Bogi, right? So who is running behind Bogi? The previous Bogi. And finally, Bogi is run by the engine, and engine is run by the driver. Now, so we understand, yes, God is there. But now, where does the God stay? Where does the God is? From where do we come? So we have this material world, death happens. Then which is that place where death doesn't happen? Like if any one of you ask a question, now just ask your heart, but does any one of us like to die? Nobody wants to die. Does anybody wants to be unhappy in this world? Nobody wants to be unhappy in this world. Nobody wants to be unhappy in this world. We want one money because this is the nature of soul. So we are children of God from the spiritual world, right? So we came from the... So So when we leave the company of God and come to this world, our pure spiritual nature becomes covered over. You see? In this way, the soul is forced to take birth in this material world again and again. Due to desires in the mind and due to good and bad karma, we keep going from one body to another. So Jesus said, this world is like a bridge. Do not build a house upon it. Use this material world to go to spiritual world. Right? So where does a soul come from? From the spiritual world. Now just think about it. Does all of you want to go to a place where is all happiness? Do you all want to go to a place where is all happiness? Everybody loves you. There is no fear of death. You will never become old. No relative will go away in our life. And there is love. And any desire you just do, it's immediately there. And just feel love always. Nobody is there who's, no person is there who can cheat. Nobody is there to give you any suffering. No bodily disease. Whatever you want, you can do in life. Please raise your hand if you want to go to such a place. It's a very serious question to discuss, because that's how we discuss our, make our discussion further. That do you really want to go to such a place where everywhere is happiness and there is no misery, no tension? And that's what the word Vaikuntha means. Vaikuntha, where there is no kunta, no anxiety, no birth, no disease, no old age, and no death. There. So this is what is the philosophy of Bhagavad Gita telling Arjuna, why are you suffering in this world? Come back to spiritual world. Come back to spiritual world there. And that's what we all are looking for in life there. Okay. Now another question asks, do you doubt whether such a world exists? Now I ask, you want to go such a world. Now my another question is that do you doubt whether such a world exists? Okay, first we'll lower all the hands on the previous question. And then I'll again ask, we didn't have a poll question on this, that do you doubt that such a world exists? How many of you feel a doubt about it? That maybe, may not be, such a world exists. Right there. So this doubt may come in our mind. There may not be. Because we have so much pain in this world, so now we don't understand that one world will be like this, where everything will be good. And it looks like a fairy tale. But there is a logic, there is a reason, and a scriptural conformity to this. What is scriptural conformity? You see, this material world is like a movie. Like we told about, material world is a movie. So just like you watch a movie, so it looks very nice. You're taking your tears also coming when you're watching the movie. The tears are also coming and everything is happening. But when the movie is over, everything is over. You can't do anything about it. So same way, when this life is over, you can't do anything about it. It's like a movie. So if this life is not real, then there should be real life somewhere. Somewhere real life should exist. If this is not real life, yes, yes or no? Then if this life is not real, in the sense it's not permanent, it will end at some point of time. There should be a, like movie has some real shooting going somewhere. And that's how the movie comes. So because we are trying to do there, so there will be some world where there. Now the soul has a desire to live forever. Then there must be some world where soul can live forever. We have a desire to be always happy. Then there is a world where all happiness. Now another thing, we talk about Ishvara, that Krishna is the Supreme Lord. Now Lord doesn't live alone. See, just like a king lives with his queen, with his praja and everything. So Lord also lives in his kingdom, where his queen is there, where his praja is there, and all happy beings. Even you see, when Lord Ram was there, Ayodhya Vasis was so happy. Ram, people talk about it. Why? Because the kingdom of God is there. So when Lord Krishna, Rama, they come here and show their pastime, so they show how they are doing these pastimes in the spiritual world. And they come to attract us there. In fact, there have been many incidences of, you know, aliens, flying identities and other things, which have been confirmed there. Some are hoax, but some are being confirmed also. So there are life exists within other planets in this world, which we do not know. Then what to say of life beyond this universe? Because we even yet not know from science what is the end of this universe. And that's where the concept of spiritual world comes. And we are not talking on our authority. Who's standing? Lord Krishna is standing in Bhagavad Gita. And even Bible talks about it. Even other religions talk about the spiritual world. So what happens in the spiritual world? So where does the self come to the spiritual world? There. So there, every word is a song. Every walk is a dance. Water is like nectar. All living beings are pure. There is no old age, disease, or every word is a song. Because it's just singing there. And so when Lord Krishna comes here, everything is like this. His play with his group of friends, his mother, Yashoda loving Krishna, his eternal being. That is our real eternal home where we can get ultimate, unending happiness. The soul, and that's our goal of life, is to return back home, back to Godhead. So that's our goal of life. Right? And Krishna's, not Krishna, says in Bhagavad Gita. You recite after me. Na tad bhasyato suryo. Na shashanko na pavakah. Yadgatva na nivartante. Tadhamam paramam mamah. The supreme abode of mind is not illumined by the sun or moon, nor by fire or electricity. Those who reach it never return to this material. So there is no, why there is no need of moon, sun, fire, electricity? We're self-illuminated. In this world is darkness, but spiritual world is all light. So there is no need of sun, moon, everything. It's all effort. And what Lord is doing wonderful pastime. You see Lakshmi Narayan sitting and everyone is offering prayers to the Lord. There are different, you know, husband and wife coming together with a spiritual relationship, worshiping the Lord. Lakshmi is personally there. And everybody is so happy in a spiritual world. Whatever they desire is there and beyond the comparison. And that is the spiritual world. And this is what our scriptures talk about. Srimad Bhagavatam, you might have heard of Srimad Bhagavatam. There are two, three chapters talking about what is the description of the spiritual world. See? So a spiritual world versus material world. The spiritual world is like a real mango tree on the bank of a river. The material world is like the reflection of the mango tree in water. So you see, you've seen an upside tree, upside down tree, like you see the reflection of a tree. Like one time, the queen's necklace was stolen. And that necklace, a crow had taken. So the king announced, anybody who get that necklace, I'll give him a lot of money. So one person was searching, and he saw that necklace. He was trying to get it in the river, but he's not able to get the necklace in the river. He's able to pick up. Then the sage came, you see above that bird is holding that necklace and his reflection is coming. So then he went, took the necklace somehow from that bird and gave it to the king. So in the same way, we are seeing the reflection happiness in this world. We're trying to get happy, but we are not finding happiness. Why? Because real happiness in the spiritual world, and we are just finding a reflection. It just comes for some time and goes away. Comes for some time and then goes away. So this is the temporary happiness in this world. Right? So this is different between a spiritual world versus material world there. So our material body, see, just like we understand we are not body with spirit soul. We don't see spirit soul. But we understand, yes, there is a jivatma there. Same way, there's a spiritual, this just like there's a material world, there's a spiritual world where the spirit souls stay. And in this world, it's like a jail where badatmas stay, conditioned souls. This person, this card of control, that is trying to read this person, is not able to use those biscuits. No matter is trying. So Bhagavad Gita says this material world is in compared to an upside down banyan tree. Why? Because it's a reflection of the spiritual world. So have you ever seen a tree with roots upward and branches downward? Yes, in the reflection. If you see in the river reflection of a tree, it has roots upwards and branches downwards. So therefore, this tree of material world is a reflection of the tree in the spiritual world. So our material body is a bad copy of our spiritual body. The spiritual world is like a real mango tree on the bank of a river. The material world is like the reflection of the mango tree in water. Material world is a perfect reflection of the spiritual world. See, there's a fake marble, that means there's a real marble, right? People put fake marble. Why? Because there's also real marble. People have fake currency because there's a real currency. People make plastic mangoes because they are real mangoes. We have mental beauty because Krishna has spiritual beauty. So, the point is mental beauty is coming from spiritual beauty. So, if there is a fake, like the happiness in this world, we don't get it. We just think to be. So, there should be a real happiness in the spiritual world. So, beauty is not in the material body, which is just a bag of flesh and bones. But in the spirit soul, a part and parcel of supremely attractive personality of God and Shri Krishna. So he said that all opulences are there in Lord Shri Krishna. And Lord says, Antakale chamame vasvaranta palevam dhyapariyati samadhamayati asante. Whoever at the end of his time puts his body remembering me alone at once attains my nature. Of this, there is no doubt. Therefore, Arjuna, you should always think of me in the form of Krishna, the same time, carry out your prescribed duty of fighting. And with your activity dedicated to me and your mind and intelligence fixed on me, you will attain me without doubt. So now, so Lord is saying here, you should remember me while at the time of. But how should we live life? So see, whatever we remember throughout the death is a very painful experience. So what happened? The whole realm of our life is shown. And whatever we are most attached to, that only will stuck up at the end of death. So we are attached to God, then God's form come, and then you go to spiritual world. Whatever attachments will come, that all will come. And that attachment we will choose, and that's the destination we will get. So if throughout your life you're remembering God consciously, then at the time of death, naturally remember God. And God says, if my serious devotee forgets to remember me, not able to remember me, I remember my devotee. I force my remembrance into him. So for a devotee, there is no way. And this question says, Manmana Bhagavato Madhyaji Maam Namaskuru Maam Ehti Satyante Prajana Kurvasmi. This is a message of Bhagavad Gita. Become my devotee, remember me, worship me. And by this, you will come back to me, Arjuna. I'm telling you because you're my good friend there. So this is the Bhakti Yoga there. So yes, we should chant the Mahamantra at the time of last breath. And for practicing it, you have to practice it every day. So every day we should chant the holy name. Then you're able to chant at the time of death. And the best way to remember the Lord is chanting the holy names of the Lord. Suicide case, if somebody commits suicide, they get a ghostly body because committing suicide is a very great sin actually. So don't think, okay, I'll remember the Lord and commit suicide because the pain will happen so much, you will forget about the Lord and there are likely chances to become a ghost. Okay, Nangin ji had a question. Yes, Nangin.
Oh, Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare. You told that Vaikuntha will not be having any issues or any problems, desires, nothing will be there. Everything is in Bhagavata, I read the story of the Saptarishis giving curse to they showed their ahankara on them. So how can ahankara can be created in the spiritual world of Vaikuntha? And there, how can they give curses to their lord? This one, of the,
yes,
like in our normal world type only, it has happened there. So,
yes, yes. How can it can happen in the spiritual world? And Krishna himself says, "Yad gata na nivartantaham paman." So, also very, very beautiful point. See, that Vaikuntha is Rama Vaikuntha. It's not Mahavaikuntha, which story is mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam. That Rama Vaikuntha lies within this, is an eternal Vaikuntha, but lies within this mental universe above Satyaloka. This is the first thing. Second thing, Lord wanted to fight. And the best devotee to fight his own devotees. So, Lord arranged this, that Jaya Vijay cursed by Kumaras. So after that, Kumaras got bhakti. The Lord gave a choice to the Jaya Vijay that you take 100 births as devotees and come back, or 3 births as a demon. So Jaya Vijay, knowing that we want to give pleasure to the Lord in fighting, they came as demons. And what a terror they created. Now after a few days, 25th of my year, Narsingh Chaturdashi, Hiranyakashipu was the same Jaya Vijay, right? He created such a terror, all demons flew in all directions. And everybody was chanting, Hum Hiranyakashipu Nama. And everybody said, and Lord came and killed him there. So he was always remembering Lord Vishnu only, even in that body. Then he became Ravana. Then he became Shishupal. And finally, Shishupal went to spiritual world. So their coming was just like a flash, but while they came also, they were remembering the Lord in enmity there. So they just went. And for the living entity to come from there and go back, it's just a flash. It's just a flash there. So it all happened in Lord's arrangement, right?
But as per now, this there are two Vaikunthas as per this one.
So this Vaikuntha is called Rama Vaikuntha, is within this Rama boundary of this universe only, but it's an eternal Vaikuntha there, but it's above Satya Loka. Okay. And there's a Maha Vaikuntha beyond the universe there.
Okay, so the spiritual world is Maha Vaikuntha.
Mahavaikuntha, that is also Mahavaikuntha, but Lord manifests within this universe only. There is again Shweta Deep also, where Lord Shirodakshaya Vishnu stays. So actually everything has a lot of details, you know, in scriptures mentioned, every reason, everything is given. Only thing we need, a right authority, a right understanding to understand all this.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
Dhanyavad. Okay, I think Pankaj had a question. Yes, Pankaj. You had a question, Pankaj? Pankajji? Okay, you had a question. Does God keep balance among the number of creatures living in this world? Actually, souls are all eternal. So like they change from one species to another. Like you see human population increasing. Because many human beings are going to animal life, or people are supposed to rise to, you know, demigods. But because human beings are not doing much punya, so they're getting more. And those animal species, they're also becoming humans. So therefore, the human population seems to be increasing. But the soul remains constant, right? But they change from one there. And those who get liberation, they go back to spiritual world. So if we have happiness or sadness, yes, it is experienced in the mind. And because the soul identifies with the mind, he perceives it like this. Okay, so now I have another slide of my presentation. A 10-minute presentation is remaining more. So what it says, okay, now we are talking about that we should remember the Lord. So how should we mold our life? See, that day, remember, I couldn't take this 3 modes. You remember 3 modes there? So now how we can take help of these 3 modes to make our life come in mode of goodness and beyond, so that we can reach to the spiritual world. So devotee means we should live in life in mode of goodness. So that's what we'll explain now in the coming slides. So explanation based on 3 modes. Why some people behave differently from others in terms of liking, speech, taste, language, thinking, etc. No? Why people have yes, some say yes, some say no. And I don't know how I get angry. Others should tolerate. I have bad habits. Somehow it's uncontrollable. I'm not able to give it up. So what is the answer? 3 modes. So just like chains bind us, mental chains bind us. Similarly, these 3 modes also bind us. For example, sattva-guna, mode of goodness. Raja-guna, mode of passion. Tama-guna, mode of ignorance. There. So what is the quality and sense of happiness? Tatra sattvam nirmalatva prakashak prakashak gamnamayam sukh sangena badanati jnana sangena chanaga. For sinless one, the mode of goodness, being purer than others, is illuminating and it frees one from all sinful reactions. Those situated in that mode became conditioned by a sense of happiness and knowledge. So you see, scientists, poet, philosopher, they have knowledge and they seem to be relatively more happy, right? But they think this world is also a good place and they don't try to think to go to spiritual world. That's a mode of goodness is also binding. But this mode of goodness is better than mode of passion and mode of ignorance. So mode of goodness means person is happy and is in knowledge of what is wrong. The mode of passion means raga, trishna and sangha. Raga means attraction between man and woman. Trishna is hankering for sense objects. Sangha is longing for association. The mode of passion is born of unlimited desires and longings, O son of Kunti. And because of this, the embodied living entity is bound to material, fruitive actions. And mode of ignorance is nidra alasya pramad. Person likes to sleep, cry, shout. O son of Bharata, know that the mode of darkness born of ignorance is the delusion of all embodied living entities. The results of this mode are madness, indolence, sleep, which bind the conditioned soul. An animal also in three modes, like cow is in mode of goodness, lion is in mode of passion, and jackal is in mode of ignorance. You see, cow will not harm any other living entity. Just take, eat vegetarian food, take grass, give milk to others, always doing good to others, cow. You see, king, lion, he will go, fear, all animals will fear him, you know, there. And jackal will never hunt his own prey. He will take what is the bacha kucha. She is lazy fool, lazy animal, jackal. So one is in goodness, passion, and ignorance. So now how to understand which mode I'm situated in? So everything is in three modes: people, animals, plants, times of day. Like morning is in goodness, daytime is in passion, night is in ignorance. Food. There are food is in mode of goodness, food is in passion, food is in ignorance. Thinking, feeling, willing, and acting. All these things are in mode of ignorance, passion, and goodness. Even austerity, charity, knowledge, everything. Now, for example, insecure. If somebody is insecure, which mode you will say? So you write me answers in chat of this. So these are some expressions. So you have to tell which mode they are in. Insecurity. Somebody is feeling insecure. So he's in which mode? Goodness, passion, ignorance. Please write your answers in chat. Oh, no chats are coming. If somebody is insecure, which mode it is? Goodness, passion, or ignorance? Ignorance. Insecurity is in ignorance. Then aggressive and self-righteousness, passion. Dusty and greedy for more and more, passion. Depressed and societal thoughts comes in ignorance. So as soon as somebody chants, passion and ignorance goes away and one comes to goodness. So somebody has a societal thought, tell him to chant Hare Krishna. Can see things in the right position, goodness. Illusion, mad and directionless, ignorance. Simple living, goodness. Clear direction, purpose, goodness. Lazy and tendency to postpone, ignorance. Effective state of mind, goodness. So these are the symptoms in goodness, passion, and ignorance. Now, it's a family in three modes, right? So I will ask you, which family is in which mode? You have to write. In a sequence, you should write GPI, goodness, passion, ignorance. The first family is Dr. Ravi Shankar. He's a local MD. He is a thoughtful, qualified man, respected for doing his job honestly and selflessly. And he and his wife decided to not eat meat as it involves killing other animals and also do not take any intoxication. Every day they spend some time in the morning praying to God, and also they realize that we will be faithful to each other as a partner. We won't look outside our marriage. And they like countryside, they like cows. So which mode they are, you have to tell them. Then second family, John and Betty, they never got married, but stay together. But they live together. John earns by paddling drunks, and they decided that they will not follow any religion. They spend their time sleeping at least 10 or 12 hours a day. And they take drugs and other things. So which mode it is? You can put in the chat box. Right? Huh? Then third is Larry Smith, girls around the breakfast, and Smith in time to fight traffic on the office. He's so busy that he has to, you know, gulp down the breakfast also. I've seen also in Bangalore, the traffic light winning and people eating their sandwiches. and go on bike, he's taking out sandwich and eating, and then traffic light comes and then person goes. And there he sits all day dealing with different headache and call it hard job, but worth it. Money is the honey there. And that's more, and they go to some temple or a church, you know, on a Sunday only. Other time they want to enjoy life. Right? So family, three modes. So you have to write which family is in which mode. So I'm waiting for your answers. So please write to me. Okay, so so right answer, family one is in goodness, family two is in ignorance, and family three is in passion. So many have given good answer. Nilesh, Yash Thakur, Nagendji, Sandeep Panchal, so nice, all of you are understanding the subject matter. Dikshit, Sumit, Vijayashree, so many of you have given a right answer of it there. So now, so we have to live a life in mode of goodness and even come out of mode of goodness. How? Krishna says, Mamya vicharena bhakti yogena sevate sa guna samate tan brahmbhuvaya kalpate. When we engage in full devotional service, unflinching in all circumstances, advance transcends the modes of mental nature and then comes to the level of Brahma. That means he got liberated, come to the spiritual world. So what you have to do? Abhicharena bhakti yoga. So what is this bhakti yoga? That's what we are going to see tomorrow. So tomorrow is going to be the most special session where you will have blessings from Lord Jagannath from our temple, right? You want blessing Lord Jagannath, so please come tomorrow. And we'll discuss about, there are many yogas, Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Ashtanga Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, which is the best yoga. How to perform Bhakti Yoga and how simple it is. How simple to perform Bhakti Yoga it is there. So whatever we discuss the philosophy, the practical application, you will find it tomorrow. So please do come. Tomorrow's session is something, a very, very important session, our last session of this series there. So why is there constant change in this world? So we saw it comes to time factor. What happens after death? Person gets another body, depends on what thoughts comes at the time of death. What is this kala? Kala rupa. The Lord only comes in this world as time factor. Just he creates everything, he maintains, same way he destroys. And is there a place where there is no experience of time? Yes, that is the spiritual world. And coming to mode of goodness by performing bhakti yoga. So next session, yoga to reach the spiritual world. So how to reach the spiritual world? We need yoga. So now is the time for chanting, and after that we'll have question answers, because some questions I take in the middle. So we'll chant 54 mantras. I hope all of you are ready. So please recite after me. And if you wish, you can please open your video so that others feel inspired seeing you chanting. So repeat after me. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya.
Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya.
Prabhu Nityananda.
Prabhu Nityananda.
Shri Advaita Gadadhara.
Shri Advaita Gadadhara.
Shivasadi Gaur Bhaktivrinda.
Shivasadi Gaur Bhaktivrinda.
Yeah. So please stand with me and I will come. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण. So I hope you enjoyed this chanting. Yes. So questions now. Okay, Radish. Radish, ask a question. Maybe your voice is not coming. Okay. Sunil Sharmaji has a question. Yes, Sunilji.
Yeah, namaste Prabhuji. So I just wanted to check. I think yesterday you mentioned something about the Lord glancing something and the time related to time. It was not clear.
How this material creation is done. So Durga, So Lord glances on Durga, and then Durga starts producing all the material inspiration, all the material world. So Lord glance is what called the time factor there, time. So Lord agitates the time, the gunas, and that's how the whole creation happens. And that's how the concept of creation and destruction is there. Till now, the internal time was flowing in the spiritual world. But when Lord glance, then the relative time factor comes, which creates and destroys everything. Therefore, spiritual world is beyond creation and destruction, is eternal, is always there. Does that answer your question?
Yeah, Prabhuji. So how long does the whole thing happen? I mean, the whole...
For that, you have to study time Vedic. You have to keep coming to our sessions. Then we will come to know. As more detail we go, we'll explain. So this is a very great science. Great science. Even, you know, what is, Einstein's theory of relativity. That is also as small as compared to the science given in the Vedic scriptures.
Sure. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Hare Krishna. Mansa Mantra.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
If we compare to modes as the animals, we will be in the all three forms. Like sometimes we will be in the form of cow. Like we think as a cow, we think as a lion, and we think as a jackal sometimes. So is that good, or there should be some balance between all these three, or how should we be?
So mode of goodness is the best. So devotee life means we try to be in mode of goodness.
Okay.
Like there. And if passion is there, we use it for the service of the Lord. And that way the passion is purified. And best way is to follow a devotee lifestyle, get up early morning, be good with everyone, follow four regular principles, which we discuss tomorrow, right? No meat eating, no illicit sex, no gambling, and no meat eating, no intoxication. So these are four regular principles by which we come to mode of goodness, which we'll discuss tomorrow.
Okay, so it is bad to be in the mode of ignorance.
Mode of ignorance is required at night when you have to sleep. Otherwise, in mode of ignorance, you will not get sleep. But throughout the day, we should be try to be in goodness. There.
Okay.
And passion should be, and passion also will be there, but it should be guided by goodness. Like to do some work, you need some passion, but it should be always guided by goodness. That this passion should do creative work, doesn't destruct, do any destruction.
Okay. So it is okay to be like, if we have a long vacation, so it is okay to be lazy, or we have to ignore it. Like we have to be active all the time.
So we should be active in doing some creative work for the society. Like we also have a lockdown, right? But we, our all devotees, we have become more busy. Why? To giving Krishna consciousness to others.
Yeah.
So same way, you can utilize this time to read more Bhagavad Gita. And you're giving this time, so you can every day get up morning, chant the holy names of the Lord, and that's easily you can come in goodness. And that's the best way to utilize. So you're coming for the session is the best time of utilization, which all of you are doing here.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you for
thank coming. You.
Hare
Krishna.
Okay. Pradyum, Nagendi has a question. Yes, Nagendi.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Prabhuji, I heard that Einstein's theory of relativity is taken from Bhagavad Gita and even the hydrogen bomb. Is it right? Is it correct? Or simply they are mentioning it.
Okay, Einstein.
Einstein's theory of relativity.
Huh.
As well as the hydrogen bomb, what is made? What he made. It's all taken from Bhagavad Gita, what I heard.
No, so the formulas what he has given is not in Bhagavad Gita, but the principles are there in our Shastras. Like Einstein's theory of relativity says that time is relative, but there had been no proof to prove that time is relative. But in Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a mention that Brahmaji comes to here, planet Earth, goes back for a moment to his planet and come back. So one moment passed, you know, for his planet, but 1 year has passed on Earth. So there have been many explanations of theory of relativity in our scriptures. Same way, Ashwathama had shot a Brahmastra to kill Parikshit in the womb. So the atomic weapons were there also that time there. So the formulas he has not taken, but the principles are there in our scriptures for atom bomb and other things. No, it is there in Srimad Bhagavatam, many other places they are there.
Now, has he given credit? to our shastras or simply as he given credit to our shastras?
No. And he has to, he has invented a formula on his own only. But those things are already there in our scriptures. What he has discovered is already there in our scriptures. That is the point we are talking about. There.
Okay.
Then you
are covered.
Thank you. Hare Krishna Pradyumna. Yeah.
Yeah. Hare Krishna Prabhuji. I have a question. We say that once this soul changes, the soul changes body, and the soul is eternal. That's right. You also touched upon that human population is increasing. Okay. So why so only human population is increasing? Why that the soul always is becoming human? At the same time, we have animals and other creatures, they are decreasing. Again, we are saying this is Kali Yuga. Matlab, more and more hinsa is here. More and more cruelty is here. So at the same time, why? What is the logic that only human population will increase in that sense?
No, one thing. Do you know how much ants population is? Do you know how much elephant population is? Do you know how much tiger population is? We don't have a count of it. Okay, we may in general say tiger population is decreasing. But do you know what's the ant population on planet Earth? What's the mosquito population? What's the tree population?
No, we don't know that. That's true.
So that's true. So only we may know human population. So now some human beings are becoming animals, some animals are becoming human beings, some human beings are becoming devatas. So like this cycle is going on of birth and thing. And some human beings are getting liberated, which is very rare case, which is going to spiritual world.
Okay, fine. Maybe that may be cause. Because if trees are also to be considered as the living entity, then I think maybe. But at the same time, you see, we are cutting down trees. Animals are decreasing its number. Humans are only increasing. It looks like everybody is doing a good job, so that they are getting like upliftment from maybe other type of souls to human souls. That looks like, but which is unlike in Kali Yuga. That was my only like you can say that curiosity is coming to my mind.
Yes.
Okay, if I can, I am allowed to ask one more question. What is the difference between Bhagavad Gita? I understand that is Lord Krishna spoke to Arjuna and vice versa, the conversation. So you are always mentioning one more scripture like Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam. So
yes.
What is Srimad Bhagavatam? What is the difference between Bhagavatam,
yeah. Bhagavad Gita,
Bhagavatam? Yeah.
Bhagavad Gita is spoken by the Lord, and Srimad Bhagavatam is spoken by Vyasadeva to Sukhdeva Goswami, and Sukhdeva Goswami speak to Parikshit. Now, since Srimad Bhagavatam is spoken by the devotee, it has more glories about the Lord. And Srimad Bhagavatam, we study after reading Bhagavad Gita. There. So when you understand Bhagavad Gita, first book is Bhagavad Gita. And after that, Srimad Bhagavatam we study, where everything else, where a lot more details are there about Lord and Lord's devotees and how to do devotional service to the Lord. But first we have to read Bhagavad Gita.
Okay. Dhanyavad, Prabhuji. Dhanyavad.
Yes, Shobhit.
गुरु जी कल राधे राधे कल मैंने आपसे पूछा था कि शिव कौन है और मतलब विष्णु कौन है जैसे कि विष्णु पुराण में कहा जाता है विष्णु को ही शिव कहा गया है और शिव पुराण में शिव के ही एक नाम विष्णु है तो ये चीज पूछना है कि मतलब शिव कौन है और वो कौन है
जैसे मिल्क दही में बन जाता है पर दही दूध नहीं बनता है पर दूध दही बनता है राइट
जी
तो सेम वे विष्णु जी से शिव जी आते हैं शिव जी से विष्णु जी नहीं आते
अच्छा
ये तो पहला डिफरेंस है तो लॉर्ड शिव लॉर्ड विष्णु इज लाइक मिल्क बट व्हेन ही कम्स व्हेन ही हैज टू कम इन कांटेक्ट विद मेटल एनर्जी ही कम्स एज शिवा व्हिच कम्स इन देयर सो इट्स लाइक मिल्क कन्वर्ट टू कर्ड एंड लॉर्ड शिवा वर्शिप्स लॉर्ड कृष्णा ओनली इफ यू सी राम राम रामेति राम नामे मनोरमे इफ यू सी शिव एंड पार्वती संवाद लॉर्ड शिवा इज टीचिंग टू पार्वती वर्शिप लॉर्ड कृष्णा Worship Lord Vishnu. And he himself is meditating on Lord Sankarshan. He's always meditating on Lord
Sankarshan,
Lord Shiva. But you not see Vishnu, Lord Vishnu meditating on other devtas, vagera. He's meditating on his internal potency with the past, having past time with his devotees. There.
Yes, yes.
So that's a different. So just, there is only one Supreme Lord. Arsa. Okay. That's all. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. So how to live in the family where other members are meat eater? No problem. let them eat meat and you cook your own food slowly, slowly. Don't have any quarrel with parents. You know, treat them also nicely with relatives and thing. But you may have your own separate food, understanding, because it has a lot of consequences for us in future eating meat. And so slowly by your good behavior, your family will also change. Okay, is there any other question or should we end here? Okay, who is Nara? If Lord Narayan is Vishnu, then who is Nara? So Nara is Arjun. So Narayan came as Krishna Arjun. So Nara is also a devotee of the Lord, Nara. And they do tapasya together. So I hope all questions are okay. Rajesh ji had a gentle question. Is it gift of God that we don't remember past life? Yes. If you're remembering past life, we're not able to live this life nicely. Like you see, in all these cases, fighter pilot, what I'll say, that this life became very troubled. Now, in case of Ratnavali, the past life became a blessing because she is a devotee. Otherwise, past life just mess up our lives a little more. See, this life only we have so many troubles dealing with the things. If you remember the troubles of last life, what a nightmare is, how you died, what that person did to you, what that person did to you. So it becomes a more nightmare. And that's why the our past life is not so much recommended that we have to remember and go for past life regression in our life. Because if somebody is getting a lot of dreams and a lot of troubles, then he may go for, you know, understanding what is happening. Yes. So there is a question that in Ram Avatar, Lord Ram worshipped Lord Shiva. Where? In Rameshwara. See, Ravana was a devotee of Shiva. So Lord Ram wanted to worship Lord Shiva to show that yes, I'm atoning because I killed Ravana, his devotee, so I should appease him. So this is the heart of Lord Ram, right? That he's showing by his behavior that how all the demigods also should be respected there. And Lord loves to worship his devotees. See, Krishna is worshiping Sudama also. When Sudama comes, Krishna is washing his feet. Right? So Krishna can worship his devotee. Can't Krishna worship Lord Shiva, who is his own devotee? So dream is what? When our gross body is at rest and our subtle body is dreaming. That's a dream. No, actually, Lord Krishna is not avatar of Lord Vishnu. In fact, all the avatars comes from Lord Krishna. And it is mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, first end of third chapter. Ete chansha kala pumsam krishnastu bhagwan swayam. So first all the avatars are mentioned and then specifically about Lord Krishna is mentioned. But they are the same person. Like father is at home and father is in office. Right? So that's the difference between Lord Krishna and Lord Vishnu. Any other question anybody has about past life regression or anything past life? Okay, so we end the session here. So thank you very much for coming. And tomorrow going to be a very special session about yoga. So please, there. Hare Krishna. Actually, you are the soul. You don't have to speak with soul.
So, thank you so much. We will see all of you tomorrow, 7 o'clock. It's going to be a very special session. Final session for this.